Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, peace be with you. Dear brothers and sisters, on this most sacred night in which our Lord Jesus Christ passed over from death to life, the Church calls upon her sons and daughters scattered throughout the world to come together to watch and pray. If we keep the memorial of the Lord's Paschal solemnity in this way, listening to his word and celebrating his mysteries, then we shall have the sure hope of sharing his triumph over death and living with him in God. Let us pray. O God, who through your Son bestowed upon the faithful the fire of your glory, sanctify this new fire, we pray, and grant that by these Paschal celebrations we may be so inflamed with heavenly desires that with minds made pure we may attain festivities of unending splendor through Christ our Lord. Amen. Christ, yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega, all time belongs to him, and all the ages. To him be glory and power through every age and forever. By his holy and glorious wounds, may Christ the Lord guard us and protect us. Amen. May the light of Christ, rising in glory, dispel the darkness of our hearts and minds.
Exalt, let them exalt the hosts of heaven. Exalt, let angel ministers of God exalt. Let the trumpet of salvation sound aloud a mighty king's triumph. Be glad, let earth be glad, as glory floods her, ablaze with light from her eternal King. Let all corners of the earth be glad, knowing an end to gloom and darkness. Rejoice, let Mother Church also rejoice, arrayed with the lightning of his glory. Let this holy building shake with joy, filled with the mighty voices of the peoples. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, with ardent love of mind and heart, and with devoted service of our voice, to acclaim our God invisible, the Almighty Father, and Jesus Christ, our Lord, his Son, his only begotten, who for our sake paid Adam's debt to the eternal Father, and pouring out his own dear blood, wiped clean the record of our ancient sinfulness. These then are the feasts of Passover, in which is slain the Lamb, the one true Lamb, whose blood anoints the doorposts of believers. This is the night when once you led our forebears, Israel's children, from slavery in Egypt, and made them pass dry shod through the Red Sea. This is the night that with a pillar of fire banished the darkness of sin. This is the night that even now throughout the world sets Christian believers apart from worldly vices and from the gloom of sin, leading them to grace and joining them to his holy ones. This is the night when Christ broke the prison bars of death and rose victorious from the underworld. O wonder of your humble care for us, O love, O charity beyond all telling, to ransom a slave, you gave away your son. O truly necessary sin of Adam, destroyed completely by the death of Christ. O happy fold that earned so great, so glorious a Redeemer, the sanctifying power of this night dispels wickedness, wash us faults away, restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to mourners. Oh, truly blessed night, when things of heaven are wed to those of earth, and divine to the human. On this, your night of grace, O Holy Father, accept this candle, a solemn offering, the work of bees and of your servants' hands, an evening sacrifice of praise, this gift from your most holy church. Therefore, O Lord, we pray you, that this candle, hallowed to the honor of your name, may persevere undimmed to overcome the darkness of this night. Receive it as a pleasing fragrance, and let it mingle with the lights of heaven. May this flame be found still burning by the morning star, the one morning star who never sets, Christ your Son, who coming back from death's domain has shed his peaceful light on humanity and lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet hearts to the word of God. Let us meditate on how God in times past saved his people, and in these, the last days, has sent us his Son as our Redeemer. Let us pray that our God may complete this possible work of salvation by the fullness of redemption.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth." So God created man in his own image. In the image of God he created him, male and female he created them. And God blessed them, and God said to them, "Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth." And God said, "Behold, I have given you every plant yielding seed, which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with its seed and in its fruit. You shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, and everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food." And it was so. And God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, send forth your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Lord, send forth your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord my God, how great you are, clothed in majesty and honor, wrapped in light as with a robe.
Lord, send forth your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
You set the earth on its foundation, immovable from age to age. You wrapped it with the depths like a cloak. The waters stood higher than the mountains.
Lord, send forth your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
You make springs gush forth in the valleys. They flow in between the hills. There the birds of heaven build their nest. From the branches they sing their song.
Lord, send forth your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
From your dwelling you water the hills. By your works the earth has its full. You make the grass grow for the cattle and plants to serve mankind's need, that he may bring forth bread from the earth.
Lord, send forth your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
How many are your works, O Lord? In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Lord, send forth your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. Let us pray. O God, who wonderfully created human nature and still more wonderfully redeemed it, grant us, we pray, to set our minds against the enticements of sin, that we may merit to attain eternal joys through Christ our Lord.
A reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, the Lord said to Moses, "Why do you cry to me? Tell the sons of Israel to go forward. Lift your rod and stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, that the sons of Israel may go on dry ground through the sea. And I will harden the hearts of the Egyptians so that they shall go in after them, and I will get glory over Pharaoh and all his host, his chariots and his horsemen. And the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord, when I have gotten glory over Pharaoh, his chariots, and his horsemen." Then the angel of God, who went before the host of Israel, moved and went behind them, and the pillar of cloud moved from before them and stood behind them, coming between the host of Egypt and the host of Israel. And there was the cloud and the darkness. And the night passed without one coming near the other all night. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord drove the sea back by a strong east wind all night and made the sea dry land. And the waters were divided. And the sons of Israel went into the midst of the sea on dry ground, the waters being a wall to them on their right hand and on their left. The Egyptians pursued and went in after them into the midst of the sea, all Pharaoh's horses, his chariots, and his horsemen. And in the morning watch, the Lord, in the pillar of fire and of cloud, looked down upon the host of the Egyptians, and discomfited the host of the Egyptians, clogging their chariot wheels so that they drove heavily. And the Egyptians said, "Let us flee from before Israel, for the Lord fights for them against the Egyptians." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, that the water may come back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and upon their horsemen." So Moses stretched forth his hand over the sea, and the sea returned to its usual flow when the morning appeared. And the Egyptians fled into it. And the Lord routed the Egyptians in the midst of the sea. The waters returned and covered the chariots and the horsemen and all the host of Pharaoh that had followed them into the sea. Not so much as one of them remained. But the sons of Israel walked on dry ground through the sea, the waters being a wall to them on their right hand and on their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel that day from the hand of the Egyptians. And Israel saw the Egyptians dead upon the seashore. And Israel saw the great work which the Lord did against the Egyptians. And the people feared the Lord. And they believed in the Lord and in his servant Moses. Then Moses and the sons of Israel sang this song to the Lord, saying, "I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider he has thrown into the sea." I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider he has thrown into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. This is my God, and I will praise him, my father's God, and I will exalt him.
I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously.
The Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name. Pharaoh's chariots and his host he cast into the sea, and his picked officers are sunk in the Red Sea.
I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously.
The floods cover them. They went down into the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, glorious in power. Your right hand, O Lord, shatters the enemy.
I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously.
You will bring your people in and plant them on your own mountain, the place, O Lord, which you have made for your abode, the sanctuary, O Lord, which your hands have established. The Lord will reign forever and ever.
I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. Let us pray. O God, whose ancient wonders remain undimmed in splendor even in our day, for what you once bestowed on a single people, freeing them from Pharaoh's persecution by the power of your right hand, now you bring about as a salvation of the nations through the waters of rebirth. Grant, we pray, that the whole world may become children of Abraham and inherit the dignity of Israel's birthright. Through Christ our Lord.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, "Ho, everyone who thirsts, come to the waters, and he who has no money, come, buy and eat. Come buy wine and milk without money and without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and labor for that which does not satisfy? Listen diligently to me, and eat what is good, and delight yourselves in rich food. Incline your ear, and come to me. Hear, that your soul may live, and I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, merciful love for David. Behold, I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander for the peoples. Behold, you shall call nations that you know not, and nations that you knew not shall run to you. Because of the Lord your God and of the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Let him return to the Lord, that he may have mercy on him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain and the snow don't come down from heaven, and do not return there, but water the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I intend, and prosper in the thing for which I sent it." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation.
With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation.
Behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and will not be afraid. For the Lord God is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. With joy you will draw water from the wells of salvation.
With joy you shall draw water from the wells of salvation.
Give thanks to the Lord. Call upon his name. Make known his deeds among the nations. Proclaim that his name is exalted.
With joy you shall draw water from the wells of salvation.
Sing praises to the Lord, for he has done gloriously. Let this be known in all the earth. Shout and sing for joy, O inhabitant of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel.
With joy you shall draw water from the wells of salvation. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, sole hope of the world, who by the preaching of your prophets unveiled the mysteries of this present age, graciously increase the longing of your people, for only at the promptings of your grace do the faithful progress in any kind of virtue, through Christ our Lord. Let us pray. O God, who make this most sacred night radiant with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church a spirit of adoption, so that renewed in body and mind, we may render you undivided service. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brethren, all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. We were buried therefore with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our former man was crucified with him, so that the sinful body might be destroyed, and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For he who has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. For we know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has any dominion over him. The death he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Proclaim his holy gospel in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the Sabbath was past, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, they went to the tomb when the sun had risen. And they were saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the door of the tomb?" And looking up, they saw that the stone was rolled back, for it was very large. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, dressed in a white robe. And they were amazed. And he said to them, "Do not be amazed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him as he told you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. We welcome all those who are joining us through live streaming for this most beautiful celebration of the Easter Vigil. Death is devastation. When somebody we love passes away, we mourn the loss of that person. We feel the pain. The pain of parting with a loved one, especially if it is somebody very close to us, perhaps a child, perhaps our spouse of a number of years, a mother, a father, a very good friend. And undoubtedly, when Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome went to the tomb with spices to anoint the corpse of Jesus, they were certainly experiencing that sense of loss, the sense of a gaping wound, a sense of finality. Like us, when we are bereaved, they continued to find ways to express their love to the departed one. That is why they went with the spices to anoint him, just as we would place flowers on the grave or light a candle at home to commemorate one we loved and to show that we continue to love that person. Such actions, of course, do not only show love, but also a certain loyalty and fidelity. And despite the shamefulness of Jesus' death and the fact that almost everyone had deserted him, these three women remained loyal and faithful to him. They probably could not fully grasp his absence, his departure from this life. He had told them that he would rise again from the dead. And of course, we can understand that now with hindsight of what it meant. But I'm quite sure that these women and the apostles did not fully understand what he was saying when he spoke about his resurrection from the dead. Only in hindsight would they too have understood. But despite their lack of understanding, hope
was deep within their hearts. Even though they were engulfed by the darkness of sorrow and loss, they hoped, and they hoped because they believed, even if they did not understand. Their belief kindled that spark of hope within their hearts. And we too are people of hope, even if we too are slow in understanding many things. The two Marys and Salome had been touched in their very inner being by the presence, teaching, gentleness, forgiveness, and love of Jesus. He had changed their hearts. He had changed their whole reason for living. And we too, his disciples in this present age, we have encountered him. And because we believe, we also hope. The celebration of Easter, of the resurrection of Jesus, is the source of our hope. To strengthen our hope, we have listened in the readings to the history of God's action in the world, starting with his creation. And we know from the book of Genesis that when God looked at what he created, he found it to be very good. In his creation, he gave to us everything that we need for life. We have also listened to his action in salvation, that after man had disobeyed him, God saved his people, caught so beautifully in the reading from Exodus of the liberation of the people of Israel from oppression and leading them through the desert to the promised land. Remembering this history also makes us reflect on our own personal history, our experiences of God in our lives at different times, perhaps particularly when we were struggling, when we were uncertain about things. We felt the presence of God, his guidance and his leadership. And these experiences, which might have been very short, have helped us to persevere in hope that no matter what we encounter in life, Christ is always with us. Even in the face of one of the most profound mysteries of all time, that is the mystery of suffering, we persevere in our hope. The mystery of suffering, because the fundamental question is, how can a good God allow the innocent to suffer? And there are so many who suffer throughout the world, even as we gather here this evening. A very well-known Christian writer and leader once said that Christianity is the only religion that the world has ever known that gives meaning to suffering. Its salvific nature, its nature for the forgiveness of sins, because that is the reason Jesus died on the cross. He died in order that our sins may be forgiven. And we, as his disciples, we must, if we are going to be true disciples, share in that cross and unite our suffering with his suffering. And we do so in the belief that in uniting our suffering with his, uniting our cross with his cross, that we too, in some way, contribute to the salvation of the world. As St. Paul writes in his letter to the Colossians, "Now I rejoice in my sufferings for your sake, and in my flesh I complete what is lacking in Christ's afflictions for the sake of his body, the Church. And this is why we persevere. Because even if we don't fully understand, we believe that our sufferings can bear fruit for the salvation of others, for the salvation of the world. But we also persevere in our hope because we know that beyond that suffering, there is life. Life in its fullness. Life where every tear will be wiped away, and God will be all in all, and we will be united with him and with each other. To some extent, we have already experienced that life while we are still on earth. We have had a taste of it, which spurs us on to continue to endure. So like the woman who went to the tomb, we too remain faithful and loyal. Above all, we remain in the love of God and in our love of our neighbor. As we continue our Christian journey and our growth in spirituality, we are committed to guarding our faith by doing the following four things. Firstly, to always count our blessings, never forgetting the beauty and the goodness of God's creation. We give thanks to God for every blessing and grace we have received, knowing that while we have problems, the blessings and the graces far exceed these. Secondly, that when suffering comes our way, we will endure it patiently, making the commitment to unite whatever suffering we experience with Jesus on the cross, and praying that our suffering will contribute to the salvation of our loved ones and the salvation of the world. Thirdly, we will strive always to keep our relationship with God alive through keeping his commandments, through prayer, and through the sacraments. And finally, we will be Christ-like and reach out to others, just as Christ did throughout his life, as he reached out to those who were poor, vulnerable, and marginalized. Even on the cross, he prayed for his persecutors. On the cross, he gave Mary to the Church. And so whatever comes our way, we must never neglect to reach out to our neighbor, to recognize his or her suffering, and to try to lighten their loads.
Please stand. Dearly beloved, let us humbly invoke upon this font the grace of God, the Almighty Father, that those who from it are born anew may be numbered among the children of adoption in Christ. O God, who by invisible power accomplish a wondrous effect through sacramental signs, and who in many ways have prepared water, your creation, to show forth the grace of baptism. O God, whose Spirit in the first moments of the world's creation hovered over the waters, so that the very substance of water would even then take to itself the power to sanctify. O God, who by the outpouring of the flood foreshadowed regeneration, so that from the mystery of one and the same element of water would come an end to vice and the beginning of virtue. O God, who caused the children of Abraham to pass dry shod through the Red Sea, so that the chosen people, set free from slavery to Pharaoh, would prefigure the people of the baptized. O God, whose Son, baptized by John in the waters of the Jordan, was anointed with the Holy Spirit, and as he hung upon the cross, gave forth water from his side along with blood, and after his resurrection commanded his disciples, "Go forth, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Look now, we pray, upon the face of your church, and graciously unseal for her the fountain of baptism. May this water receive by the Holy Spirit the grace of your only begotten Son, so that human nature, created in your image and washed clean through the sacrament of baptism from all the squalor of the life of old, may be found worthy to rise to the life of newborn children through water and the Holy Spirit." May the power of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, we pray, come down through your Son into the fullness of this font, so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism into death may rise again to life with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so, now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works, and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his empty show?
I do.
Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace, in Christ Jesus our Lord, for eternal life. Amen. May extinguish your candles. We now continue with the prayers of the faithful. The Lord is risen. Heaven and earth rejoice in the reconciliation of God with all creation. Filled with Easter joy, we bring to God our needs for the Church and for the world.
We are an Easter people, and we ask God's blessing on the Church. May our witness to the resurrection be a source of joy in a world of despair and pain. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all peoples of the world during this festival of Christ's resurrection. May the gloom of malice and evil yield to a springtime of sincerity and truth. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray that the risen Lord's gift of peace may dwell in our hearts, in our homes, and in our country. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
May we share the enthusiasm of Mary Magdalene, Peter and John to be witnesses to the resurrection of Jesus by our faithfulness to his teaching and the gospel values that mark our lives. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those who have died. May they rejoice in the presence of the risen Christ. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us contemplate our risen Lord for a few moments and ask him silently for what we need. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Father, it is because of your Son's death and resurrection and the power of the Holy Spirit that our prayers are surely heard by you. Guide us today that we may be found worthy to share the resurrection of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, we ask you, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in the Paschal mysteries may, by the working of your power, bring us to the healing of eternity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this night, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. And so, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Thank you.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, Bishop Sylvester, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you alone. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most holy night of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damien, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you. Also for those to whom you have been pleased to give the new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them, as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, for ever and ever. At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. behalf of all those who are joining us through live streaming and who desire to receive the sacrament of the Eucharist but cannot because of the restrictions, I make the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray.
Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this Paschal sacrament one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. Before giving the final blessing, first and foremost, I would like to wish all of you, those present here, those joining us through live streaming, a very blessed, joy-filled, and life-filled, and grace-filled Easter. May the Lord bless you abundantly, and may you have his joy in your hearts. And to everybody who has participated in these celebrations, those who have worked very hard to make the preparations, in particular, I thank our organist and the cantors for their presence at the different services of the Triduum. Thank you very much to all of you for making these services so very beautiful and so very prayerful. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin. And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten Son endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in.
Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia. Alleluia.
something.